Okay, hi. This is Dr. Zuckerman. In front of us, we have the back of the Diowave 15 high energy laser. It comes in two models. It comes in a 10 watt and a 15 watt. Today, we're going to show you how to set it up. We're going to show you how to program it, go over all the internal features, and we're going to show you some precautions in using the laser. The first thing we do is this is called the interlock. And the interlock is used, this is the key to the laser. Without this, you cannot operate the laser. When you plug anything into this unit, it must be turned off, and two is you put it in gently. You never force anything. Always read the label. It says interlock. The red mark is at 12 o'clock. You push it in, and you just push it in and see how it locks? Out. 12 o'clock high with the red dot and in. The next feature is the foot pedal. Pulls right out. Everything, they're all the same adapters. 12 o'clock. If you put it in not at 12 o'clock, it will not go in. Do not force it or you'll break it. Slips right in. And there. See how it's in very easily. This is the foot pedal. The foot pedal is used specifically for when you're doing surgical warts and when you're doing fungus toenails. You must open it up to use it. This is the area where you press your foot. We'll demonstrate that for you. If you press it when it's closed, it will not function. It does appear to work with it closed because of these three little bars, but you press it, opens up. The last thing that needs to be plugged in, now remember, everything is turned off, is the power cord. Slips in, make sure it's tight. This is a typical classical power cord that you use in a computer. So everything is set up, the interlock, the foot pedal, and the power switch cord. That's how you turn it on, 1 and 0. That turns it on. In fact, when you turn this around, you'll see the screen coming up. So in the one position, it comes on. Now we have the screen. It says, please enter your password. It's 4 zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4. It might be in our later models, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. Please, if it doesn't work at 4 zeros, try 1, 1, 1, 1. It also should be in your manual. If you have a problem, ask us. So in this one, it's 4 zeros and you press enter. It'll go through a self-diagnostic screen. The power detection says okay. The foot switch detection. Everything says okay. So we're going through a full self testing diagnostic feature. Right now it's in a standby mode. It's set for one of our protocols, the fungus toenails. 800 on, that's time on or pulse width, 800 off at 4 watts. We have a couple proposals. We've got an 850, we've got a 3 and 30. 3 millimeter, it could be a 2 millimeter, or a 400 micron, which is a 2 millimeter, and a 600 micron, which is a 3 millimeter. That's 3 milliseconds on and 30 milliseconds off if you press this. And it's set wrong. Let's say this one happens to be set wrong for some reason. All you do is adjust. Well, actually, it isn't. We start at 4. We're going to correct this for you right now. There it is at 4. 3 milliseconds on. See the MS? 30 milliseconds off. This particular laser works in micron, milli, and seconds. We're going to press go back to proposals. And it's set. The way you know it's set correctly, it's 4, 3, 30, repeat mode. And there it is perfectly right there. So if there's a mistake with it set wrong, I showed you how to correct it very easily. You can use the plus and the minus to change the wattage at any time. You can change the power second. Now here's an important feature in all of these lasers, especially the 10, the 15, and the 30. If you're doing a nail procedure or wart procedure and you want to keep the same power, time off means the amount of time the laser beam per pulse is off. So you can just move it to 40 or 50. But usually 30 works well. The goal with warts and the goal with nails is to put as much power in with little to no pain. And that's by putting high watts and keeping the time off. and the time on small. If you want to use it, you turn it on ready. That will turn it on. You lift up the foot pedal. In this case, we're using the handpiece. This happens to be a 400 micron. We're in standby, so you got to put it in ready, and then you press down, and it will start to go on. And you move it back and forth about a centimeter and a half. You just go back and forth. You never cover two spots once. You go over the entire nail. And then you repeat it. And you're going to do it for 500 joules for the big toe and 250 for the lesser toe. Notice how comfortable this is? This is very comfortable. See, I'm doing the speed. Look at the distance I'm doing. I'll do it one more time. I feel nothing on this right now at all. You could even increase the wattage if you want to. As long as it's comfortable, you can go anywhere from 4 to 6 watts on this. Don't touch the nail. You follow the beam on the nail. You do not follow the red dot at the end of the fiber. I'm looking right at the nail. Okay. Stops it off.
Go.
We just completed doing a mock nail. You want to reset the energy to zero. So on a Howick's toenail, it's 500 joules, at least 500. You can do more, but 500 joules. And on a lesser toenail, it's 250 joules. Now let's go into menu. In the menu, here we have how you can adjust the sound. You can make it louder, or you can make it... I do not recommend you shut it off completely. The backlight, now the timer. On the timer, it's in seconds. When you're doing pain, you want to set it for at least 5 minutes, and you can convert that into 300 seconds, so you would do this. There's 300. If you uncheck, you must have that checked off. If it's not checked, and I'll show you how to use the therapy handpiece for physical medicine, the hand switch will have to be held down. So in order to press it once, and allowed to be released and work, you must have it checked off. If for some reason the handpiece has to be held down, you don't have that button checked. And that's really it. Now, proposals, I'm going to show you how to put in a proposal. Let's pick, let's rename it. Let's name it, see the board, how the board comes up? We'll name it Fungus Toenails 50. Now, I'm going to put one in that we don't typically use. And we'll call it the 50. And we're just making this up. It's mock. And now what you want to do is you got the Fungus 50. You press OK. And we're going to say it's at... Fungus 50 is going to be at 6 watts. Now you can do it on the wheel here, or you can do it here to move it. And we'll make it 6 watts. You don't have to even save these if you don't want to. 6 watts, and I'm going to move it at 500 milliseconds. Always check to make sure you're in milliseconds. 500, and we'll make it 600 off. By the way, this is a pretty effective protocol also. Pulse width is only used to control heat. Now we're at 600. So what you do is then you go back to proposal, and look at the bottom here, 6 watts, time on 500, time off 600, it's in repeat. That's the pulsing mode. And we have it. You press OK and it'll come right back up. And that's how you set up the proposals. You can put as many different proposals in. I believe you have, there's more than 8 in here, but this one lists 8. It will come up as you get down to the 8, more will come up. I believe there's 16 or 17. Okay, cut. Okay, we're going to switch from the surgical handpiece. And by the way, I want to point out the surgical handpiece. I find this to be the best and easiest way to use it. We do have a wheel, we have an antenna, but this is just so easy. And you use a piece of tape or a twisty, and you can take it off and extend it. It's so easy to use this, and it doesn't get in the way. I highly recommend this setup as opposed to the manufacturer at this time. So if you're going to do this, if you were to accidentally take this, and I don't recommend doing this, you never should take off any of the attachments with the laser on, because watch what happens. See how the alarm goes on? It's probably says fiber. It says fiber not connected. So you always want to shut off the machine. You always store your handpiece fiber inside. You unhook the top and you store it. It's like a turtle putting his head in a shell. And then you store it in a Ziploc bag. And this is that simple to do this. These fibers do not break unless you step on it, cut it, and you got it. This is the simplest way we've been using for years, and you have it. So the next part is we're going to hook up the fiber. This is the therapy fiber. It's got two parts. It's got a fiber optic and a connection to the foot pedal. So you got to unhook the foot pedal back here. It's right next to the interlock. There, that's unhooked. It's dropped. You do not need a foot pedal. You use the hand switch. And I'm going to demonstrate a few things on this. So you unhook it here. And here's your, where the foot switch goes in. It's the same thing. You turn it around. 12 o'clock high, you put it, it should be very easy to go in, see how that came in, flip it back, this is your fiber, the fiber should have a cap on it, and by the way, when this is not being used, you always take this metal screw and you screw it, you don't want to get any lint or dirt inside it, so you screw this on and you can store this right here or let it drop. This should have a cap on it too. You push it in and you turn it finger tight. Turn it back on. It's 4 zeros. And remember, when you're doing therapy, it's continuous. And we're going to take it up to 15. If it's on the dorsum of the foot, and you'll see the protocols that were given to you, you would make it a little bit less if it becomes warm. So we're at 15. And you press standby. You also want to set it, and it's ready to go. You see the beam. You turn it, you press it. Now you notice that this is running with the switch with the switch not being held. Watch this. If I unhook the timer, go back, ready, let's see what happens. See, it won't work, you have to hold it in. So you must have the check off always checked off. And that's what controls the switch. You want to put you got the right time, at least 5 minutes, and we have protocols to show you how to do that. So it's real simple. I'll always make sure this is tight. If for some reason it's saying the fiber's not connected, you tighten this up a little bit. When you turn this machine on and it doesn't fire up, there's three problems it can be. One is you don't have the button on in the back. Two is you've accidentally, if you've moved it from office to office, push this down. That's emergency. Do not use this switch to turn it on and off. It'll come back on, but do not use it routinely. Use the button in the back to shut it off and on. And that's that.